For more updates, click on subscribe and click on bell button for latest notifications. Hi friends, welcome to Tech ARK IT YouTube channel. My name is Ravi. In this video session, we are going to learn about MariaDB installation. Okay.
Like, share, comment, and subscribe.
So this MariaDB is similar to the MySQL. So MySQL has been taken over by the Oracle, and the Oracle guys don't wanted to continue with the MySQL as a default. So that's why they changed this MySQL as a MariaDB, and MariaDB added some little more more capability to the MySQL. But in the server level, all the MySQL commands will work as same like a MariaDB configuration. So there is no change, like if you install MySQL or MariaDB, the PHP modules or the Java modules, ODBC and JDBC work similar to the MySQL. So maybe you have to install a little bit of MariaDB driver if you feel that any compatibility is stopping you, so that you can work in the backend applications. You can deploy MariaDB or MySQL, does not matter to the application, because the same MySQL command works on this MariaDB itself. In order to do this, so what packages you have to install? So in by default in RHCE 7, if you install MySQL also, it installs MariaDB. But if in particular to MySQL, if you want to install on the CentOS 7 or RHCE 7, you have to map the MySQL repository to this server and install that one. But similar way, if you want to use MariaDB, this is the process you have to follow. Yum install MariaDB and say MariaDB-client. So both the services you have to install. So MariaDB is going to be installed right now. So MariaDB server package has not installed in the previous command. So I have to install this. This is the MariaDB server package you have to install in order to start the MariaDB service. So it's going to be set up the MariaDB test packages as well. Now systemctl enable mariadb.service. Now the service has been enabled. Systemctl and type start mariadb.service. Now you have to enable the firewall ports, firewall -cmd -permanent -add service equal to MySQL. So this is the port number you have to add. In my case, my firewall is stopped, that's why this command does not work. In your case, if firewall is enabled, you have to do these two commands to start the allow these services to be communicated to the external host, or if you want to connect from remote to this database, you can connect it using this service enabling by this port on the firewall. Now so let's go and verify that ss command -tulnp and say that grepping for maybe MySQL. You can see this, the port is running over here and it is listening on the port. You can see this, and you can go MySQL underscore secure installation, so that this will set up your communication like the default configuration. First of all, I do not have any root password for this one setting, so just enter it and say if you want to set the root password, say yes, I want to set the root password, and set the root password over here and enter it, and remove the anonymous user. So I don't want it to other remote anonymous users to be accessed to my MariaDB instance, so I'm just removing it. Disallow root remote login. So if your if you want your database instance to be accessed remotely, then say that no. If you don't want to allow remotely, you want to use only for the local applications to be accessed on the local server itself, say yes. Okay, disallow root login remotely, no. Okay, I want to allow remote login. So remote test databases, maybe if you want, you can remove it and reload the privileges. Now done. If you want to log into this one, MySQL iPhone U root and iPhone password, you have to enter the password. Now you can see that the MariaDB has been used. So now say that show databases, and you can see that, so there is no databases over here. You can say that create database. Database name, maybe I can give that take ArkIT, something like this. And now show databases. You can see that the databases has been created successfully. Now exit from this, and you can go and log in from the remote if you want. Okay, or else if you want to create some tables on that one, you can also use something like MySQL -u and say that username and password, you can simply provide over here, and use tech ARKIT database. I would like to create that tables on this. Say that show tables, if you have any, it will show. So I do not have any tables over here, that's why it says that it's a empty one. Now what I'm going to do is that create table and say that employees is my table name, and I say over here is that enabling process and closing process. In this ID init, maybe say that the value is 10, and name, employee name, I'm going to say over here, and it is going to be a varchar. And how many characters you can enable, maybe I can say that 70 characters I enable on the name. And I'm going to say that emp id. okay, maybe you can see that employee id over here, and say it's going to be again a varchar. Maybe in employee id I have decimals and numeric numbers, and I say that is going to be a 20 numbers, and say that maybe something like anything, the mobile number, something like this. I say mobile number, this is going to be a 10 numbers, mobile number would be 10 numbers, and say mail id. Okay, and mail id is going to be a varchar again, and maybe you can say that's 10 IDs or 12, maybe depends on how the organization clear the email address. So here I'm going to create the table with the table name called employees. In this, I'm going to create a columns called ID, name, employee ID. Okay, ID in the sense, not the employee ID, this is the default ID number, and the employee ID and number, the mobile number and mail ID. So it says that show tables, and you can see that describe employees, you can see this, our table has been created like this. Now if you want to add some data to that one, you can use this insert statement. Maybe I can say that insert, and say insert into employees. Maybe you can copy paste from over here, and say values. Okay, close and open brass, and say that within the quotation I say one, the number one I'm going to edit over here, and say that next one would be a employee name, which is going to be a Ravi, and maybe the mobile number, I'm going to say that anyone 1 2 3 4 5 6 7 8 9 10. Okay, this is the mobile number I'm just going to give, and email ID. So email ID, the sense I say that aravi@server-computer.com. That's it, right? So the first field is ID 1 and name is Ravi and mobile number, sorry, employee ID number. So maybe we missed it over here. After this name, I'm going to give this employee ID number like 1 2 3 4. Right, and mobile number and email address. Let's say that, enter, and you have to end up with the semicolon always, and say that select star from employees, and I'm going to see the data. What is the data I have inserted over here? Right, so here in the email ID, why this is only numbers over here, because we put only some 12 characters, something like that. That's why the varchar is truncated your values to the 12. Okay, now if you want to update any statement over here, example, say if you want to update the email address or the employee ID, something like zero rows affected. Now you can see this, the ID number has been changed to 2. Okay, like this you can use user creation also. You can say that create user, something like that, create user. Maybe I would like to create the username called Ravi, and maybe you can use percentage. By default it takes the local host, and identified by password. So what is the password you are going to give over here? Say that the my password is password only, and say end up with this semicolon. The user has been created over here. Okay, maybe you can grant the user permissions to that table, something like this, using the grant statement. Grant, and I'm going to say that select update delete insert. So these are the statements the user is going to be get on, where it's going to be get. So maybe on the table. So I'm going to give this database name as take ARKIT dot star. So on all the tables of that database, I'm going to give to Ravi at localhost. Mind, I'm going to granting this privileges to the Ravi. So the user, I have created Ravi, and the user has the permissions to select, update, delete, insert on this particular database and all the tables. Like this, what you can do, that you can use these methods to create the MariaDB installation and create the database, insert the data, update the data, select statement, and grant and create the users and grant the permissions to that particular user. That's about MariaDB, guys. Thanks for watching. Stay tuned. Please subscribe to the channel for more upcoming videos and courses. Please follow us on social networking sites. If you have any technical related questions, you can ask.